1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 57 and 58. Verse 57 says, "But thanks be to God who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ." And verse 58, "Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your labor in the Lord is not in vain." What does it mean to be steadfast? It means to be stationary, which means to stay put, stay in one place for a long time. And it has the picture, the description of someone who is firm, someone who is steady. Describes a foundation or a support or a structure in buildings that is firm, that is strong, something that is unmendable or unbendable, or something that is permanent. I'm sure we know of some people in our lives who are like that, steadfast, sure, always dependable, always there, and we know it like a rock. We can always lean on them. And God is calling us to be such a person, steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. God is calling us to be reliable, not shaky, not unpredictable. He's calling us to be like pillars in the roles that He has given us in the house of God, in the roles that He has given us, in the mission that He has given us. He's calling us to be like that, sure and unshakable and steadfast. In other words, He's saying that we should not be lured away, or we should not be enticed away from the purposes of God. He's saying that we need to be like pillars, strong, supportive, dependable in God's kingdom, in the house of God, so that people who are there can rely on us, lean on us for strength. People can actually depend on us, that and people can be inspired by us. So don't be swayed by disappointments. Don't be swayed by regrets. Don't be swayed by enticements or inducements of the evil one. But be steadfast, be sure. And he reminds us that that we need to be steadfast, abounding in the work of the Lord. Let the work of the Lord abound, which means to exceed, which means to excel, and let it overflow, to get better and to better and be better, the work of the Lord. So the Lord, may He make us strong, may He make us steadfast, and let that be our confession, that even some of the flaws in our personalities, may those weaknesses be overshadowed by the power of the Lord. May those weaknesses in our personalities be overshadowed by the strength of the Lord, that we will be steadfast. Let's pray. So Lord, we pray that you would enable us to be steadfast and strong and sure, immovable, and always abounding in your work, O God. I pray that you will cause this to happen, Lord. And I just pray that your power will overshadow all our limitations and all our personalities and all the flaws and weaknesses in our personalities, God. And I pray that you would cause us to be dependable. You would cause us to be reliable, so that people can lean on, people can draw strength, O God, from us, and be inspired, Lord, to follow you. We ask this in the precious name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.